Hello guys, my name is Matt and this is the pilot episode of Pimp My Mini. This is the show when I take the old damaged models and turn them in something new. For the first episode we have the Captain Draco from Space Marines. In this case I bought this guy on online auction, so I don't know who was the previous owner. And the miniature is in a pretty bad shape because he's missing a few of his parts. But the paint job is like very usual, so it's something you can see on the tables when just the beginners painting their miniatures. And I must say my first paint jobs were far worse than that. And as I said, I got this guy from online auction, but if you want your miniature to appear in the future episodes, just check the description box for the link to online form where you can submit your miniature. Okay, so let's do this. The first thing I need to do is to remove the paint from the miniature, so I will throw him into my secret formula and leave it for a few days. Okay, so our guy spent a few days in the paint removing solvent, so now it's the time to remove the paint from him completely. And there is not only paint I need to remove, because there is also a lot of glue. But there is not a lot I can do with the chemicals, so I just try to strip the paint using every tool I have in my workshop. So I just need to polish him the best I can. Okay, so I think I did pretty good job removing the paint. It's also obviously it's not perfect, but I removed most of the paint he's got and most of the glue. And another step is to give him new set of weapons and the backpack. And I need to pin every part because there is no way they will stay on the model only with glue. So I need to drill holes and just assemble everything with new pins. I also drilled the holes in his feet so I can keep him on the cork during the paint job. And here comes brand new Captain Draco. All the parts aren't perfect fit in every way, so I will need to do a little bit of green stuff work, but that's nothing. He looks like new model, so I'm pretty happy with the result. He has all the parts that he should have in the beginning, so I think I can start the actual paint job on him. I just need to prim him off screen and show you the first step to the new paint job on our guy. Okay, so I have the black primer on him and I can start the airbrushing. I want to airbrush the most important part, which is the black armor, so I will be doing this whole model in black, which means just spraying him with different shades of gray and keeping the very high contrast. Besides doing the airbrush work on the black armor, I also want to spray his robe with very light gray because it will be easier to paint with white over the light gray instead of full black. So yeah, this is like one extra step to make my job easier in the end. And obviously the airbrush helps a lot, especially with the black armor, but I will still need to do a lot of work with regular brush, which you will see when I start to actually finish up his armor. But yeah, if you don't use airbrush, I really recommend that. Now I have all the base work done, so I can actually start to paint something with a hand brush. And my plan is to get his armor even darker in the darker places and even brighter in the bright places. So yeah, I want to drive the contrast on his armor as far as I can go, so it will be a little bit shiny. And that's how his new black armor looks. So I think I did a good job and I really like the result. So I have like the biggest part of the model done. Now I can go to next one, which will be his robe and his shoulder pad, which are both white. I want to have his shoulder pad white on the gray base and his robe white but on the brown base. So yeah, I just do it with few glazes and it should do the job. I have really nice base for the robes and the shoulder pad, so it shouldn't take much time. And here are the new robes and the new shoulder pad. So I think in the term of the whole model area, we have the most job done. But as you know, the devil is in the details. So I have still a lot of work to do. And the next step will be to paint his metal parts, which will be painted as a steel with true metallic metal, which means just using the silver paint and wash it with Nuln oil, which is like the best black wash ever. And maybe a little bit of gold here and there. So yeah, let's do that. I'm thinking he looks more and more like the classic paint job from AV Metal Team, but that's good. I want to have him as true to the Warhammer lore as possible. And the next step is to paint his face. I want to paint his face as well as his mask, so I will have like the good idea how to fit other details to the general look, because obviously the face is one of the most important details on the model. We are almost there. We have the armor, the robes, metal, and his skin. So I think I will spare you commenting on the every other detail, and I will just go ahead, finish him up, and show you the final product. And here it is, finished Captain Draco. Almost brand new, or at least look like brand new. So the details I did is the power sword, which is green and almost glowing, and the decals on his chest and the shoulder pad, which is the Black Templar Maltan cross. I didn't want to do the freehand because I just didn't feel like it. And I believe the decals do pretty good job. I used the resin base from Micro Art Studio, which I had from other projects, so I think it fits. And all the other details I had to do is like the purity seal, the tubes, and some minor details. So that's it. This guy went far away from the online auction to this. So let's do a little recap. That's all for today. I hope you like the Pimp My Mini formula and you enjoyed this episode. If you are interested in more of my work, see the studiojollyroger.com, and see you next time. Cheers!